In many ways, these are very treacherous times that we are living in. There is a virus out there and it is real. But how we respond to this time is crucial. Let me remind you that God is still on the throne. He's our protector and He is our wisdom. There are things that we need to do in many areas to keep us alert about what is going on and how to respond. There are natural things that we need to do to stay protected. We need to stay healthy. We need to exercise. We need to avoid the junk. And we need to build up our immune system. But what far outweighs that is to trust God more than ever to be our protector, our wisdom, and our healer. I believe there may even be times that God will speak to us and say, "Don't enter that place. It is not safe today." I mean, who knows? We've got to be open to the voice of the Holy Spirit guiding us, leading us all the time. As we get ready to meet publicly, we must protect our people. But most of all, we must do that through prayer. We've got to stay in prayer. Listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. The other danger that we must be aware of is that the enemy would love to use this time to stop the church's meeting. Not just for a season, but he'd like to see them shut down permanently. Now, I don't believe that this is going to happen yet, but you can be sure that it is on the enemy's agenda. We as believers cannot, we must not sleep at this time. We need to understand the danger of the moment. We must awake to what could happen at this time if we don't stay vigilant. God is allowing the shake-up so that we will wake up. And anything God does is for our good. God is a good God. He's always motivated by love. If we're feeling a little bit shaken, then let it awaken us and stir us into action. We need to pray at this time. It is not a time to retreat. It is surely a time to be motivated and mobilized. It is not a time to be discouraged. This is a time to be encouraged. Be strong, be courageous, for the Lord our God is with us. He's on our side, and with Him we will overcome. He has made us to be overcomers. It is He that can alert us to the enemy's evil devices and show us how to overcome. Our job is to listen to His voice and be obedient to His directions. Now, when I say we are overcomers, unfortunately, that means that we will have things to overcome. But we must be ready for the future. We must pray. We must prepare. We are not ignorant of the devil's devices, and we must not keep silent in the battle. Our battle is in the spiritual realm, and we are called to speak life. We are called to speak peace. We are called to speak hope. The enemy will always try and silence your voice because it's powerful. Your voice is powerful. Speaking forth the word of God is powerful. We need to hear what the Lord is saying and speak it forth. We need to hear the truth of God's word resounding through the earth. The enemy would much rather that you be silent. It's time to shake off what has been holding you down. Take up your God-given authority. Speak forth His word and cause the enemy to quake. It is time to rise up. You will not come out of this time the same. Many will launch into new areas of ministry. Their ministry will change. Get ready. Prepare now, pray now. Your ministry could change. We must continue to use the voice God has given us. You know, I'm a singer, so the enemy comes along and he says, "Oh, well, I know how to shut down that voice. I'll just say, no crowds, no gathering together, all venues closed down, shut down. Yep, that's that voice closed down." Well, the thing is that I'm here out of my depth, speaking to you, doing everything online. The enemy uses social distancing to stop us, but we use social media to reach a far greater audience. Our voice cannot be stopped. God releases into new avenues. God is giving new assignments. It is not time to stay locked down and defeated. It's time to allow Holy Spirit to bring you out. Be intentional to be seeking the Lord, standing in your authority and speaking forth what God is saying. This is the time to rise up. Thanks for listening. This is Rosanna Palmer.